Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to the McPherson Recital Room here at the Laidlaw Music Centre, the first of our Wednesday lunchtime concerts this semester. Welcome also to those watching on the live stream, whether now or at a later date at home. There are, as you're aware, many concerts coming up this semester. Do consult your copy of Music in St. Andrews. Grab one before you leave the building if you don't already have one. I will just mention next week's pair of concerts. Tuesday lunchtime, St. Salvator's Chapel organ concert by Director of Chapel Music Claire Innes-Hopkins. And then on Wednesday, a concert by a brilliant young Scottish string quartet, the Ressall String Quartet, making their first appearance here. Music by Mozart and Puccini. Next Wednesday lunchtime, they're winning plaudits all over the country, so well worth coming along to hear next Wednesday if you can. We have a fantastic team of associate teachers who work with us in this building throughout the year, teaching our students and the many other members of the community who come in to follow lessons here. And it's always such a great delight to be able to present them in these concerts. Today is CASS's first performance on one of these concerts for us. And when I asked her to curate a concert today, I had no idea what she was going to come up with. So I'm absolutely thrilled that she's going to present a program entirely of her own music. And as you can see, there's quite a lot of tech involved. And I should just mention the fantastic work done by colleague Udan Meshram also to make this concert happen. Kat is going to tell you all about her compositions as we're going along. Will you please give her now a very warm welcome?
Thank you very much for coming, everybody, and welcome to my recital. I'm going to play a mixture of works this afternoon, but all written by myself for saxophone and electronics. When I was thinking up a title for this concert, you'll see in the programme, we're going to explore some works from the last 10 years of my writing, but the first one was written in 2014, and the next one not until 2023. And that's because I had a rather prolonged gap of writing in the middle of those two things, off doing other things, life going in different directions. So when I came to writing for this concert, I was really kind of struck by who I was when I wrote the first piece compared to who I was when I wrote the second one. So hence the title of the concert, This Is Lost Along the Way, all of the things that got lost along the way, some for better, some for worse. And we're going to start off with a piece called Rerenga Wairua, and it was written in 2014, inspired by my travels to New Zealand. It translates as Cape Rerenga, which if you've ever been, it's the most northerly point of the North Island of New Zealand. You feel like you're on the edge of the earth when you stood on the top of the cliffs there. You can see it's absolutely stunning, see a beautiful ocean in front of you, but also with a huge tidal rip. And the Maori believe this is the meeting of a male and female sea. It's the meeting of the Tasman Sea and the Pacific Ocean. So incredibly beautiful, but also for Maori, it is quite spiritually significant. So the title literally translates as leaping place of spirits. And the Maori believe that when they die, their souls make their way to this point on the North Island of New Zealand, and they jump off into the underworld and join the Maori homeland again by a path called the Spirit's Pathway. So it has four movements. The first is called Sunrise Over the Cape, which is a quite simple unaccompanied piece. The second one, Meeting of the Seas, which is a lot more dramatic with live looping and multiphonics. The third one is called Lost Souls. And there's a technique on the saxophone where you can play effectively like a brass instrument. You can put all of your fingers down and then voice the harmonics yourself. And it gives a slightly kind of eerie, slightly detuned, haunting feel. So you'll hear that in that one. And the last one is a sort of feeling of coming home with Spirit's Pathway. So this is Rerenga Wairua. Thank you.
Thank you.
The next piece I'm going to play for you is a piece called Maestra. And this was written for a dear friend and mentor of mine who sadly died last year. Who was my piano teacher and ultimately the reason that I was able to become a musician. It has three movements. The first one is called Grit. So Anne was an incredibly gritty person. She was a working class woman from Grimsby, born in the early 1930s, forced to leave school because she lost her mum young and work in the family business, but decided that she wanted to play the piano and saved up and bought herself piano lessons and ended up ultimately having lessons with Benjamin Britten, earning a PhD, writing books, an honorary doctorate, etc., etc. So very inspiring lady. The second movement is called Presence, and you'll hear a constant figure in the piano in the background with a kind of piper's lament over the top from a saxophone. And the third movement is called Influence, and you'll hear that as the melody starts in the piano, the saxophone kind of picks up little bits of that and gradually evolves into its own thing, and it's kind of a metaphor really for the teaching relationship. So this is Maestra, and it's for Anne.
Thank you.
the final piece that I'm going to play you is a very recent work. And this is called The Maze of Daedalus. So if you're not up on your mythology, Daedalus was an architect in ancient Greece, famed for building the labyrinth that contained the Minotaur. And I got to thinking of mazes as kind of a little bit more esoterically, as the thoughts and the patterns that trap us in our own brains and our own behaviors. So this is kind of a story of running through, sort of being trapped in a maze and trying to escape. But you might know that Daedalus also has another mythology story attached to him. He also was the father of Icarus, and he was imprisoned. Later, he fell out of favor with the king and was imprisoned in a castle. But he built his own wings and flew out. So you will notice that mazes never have a roof, so perhaps eventually we can build our own wings and fly out. So this is four movements. The first one is called Solitude, the second, Unravelling, the third, Glimmer, and the final movement is Flight. Before I deplay, I'd like to say a huge thank you to Adyan. As you can see, there's a lot of gear that comes with me. I'm not a standard lunchtime recital. So I've been incredibly grateful for all of his tech input and his lighting input and everybody that's helped out on that front today, because despite what you might see, I'm a bit of a technophobe. So thank you very much, Adyan, for all your help, and thank you everybody for coming. This is The Maze of Daedalus.